Let's start the central idea analysis of this reading comprehension. This is the CAT 2019 based RC. War, natural disasters, and climate change are destroying some of the world's most precious cultural sites. And Google is trying to preserve these wonders by allowing users access to 3D images of these treasures through its site. But the project is raising questions about Google's motivations, about who should own the digital copyrights. Some critics call it a form of digital colonialism. And when it comes to archaeological treasures, losses have been mounting. So, what are we talking about here? We are talking about the different forms of destruction being caused to the archaeological sites, right? So, archaeological sites, these are being affected by the kinds of different destruction caused by mankind, right? And then it talks about that Google is trying to do 3D preservation, right? And then there is an example. ISIS blew up parts of city in Syria, and then in Myanmar there were temples destroyed. In earlier, archaeologists and historians had for restorations, all they had were photos, drawings, remnants, and intuition. But now there are 3D images, etc. So Google is trying to do 3D preservation, but then there are questions being raised, right? Questions about Google's motivation, and or we can say questions on copyright. These are being raised. So that is what the first paragraph is all about, right? Okay, let's go to para number two. The second paragraph talks about that. So earlier, for the first para ends by saying that there were only photos and drawings, but that's changing. Now in Bagan, if you see, before the earthquake, many of the temple sites were scanned, and the scans are on the Google Arts and Culture site. So the digital renditions allow viewers to visually wander the halls of the temple, look up closer paintings, and turn the building over to look up at its chambers. Now here, what the point here we are talking about is that these digital renditions that Google has created, they allow virtual lookups basically, right? And further it says that the images of temples in Bagan, they are part of collaboration with SciArc. It's a non-profit entity which creates 3D scanning of historical sites. And Google says it does not make money off it, but it's basically on a mission to make the world information available and useful. So it is, according to Google, it's a not-for-profit tie-up that it is working on, and that is something which it does to promote its objective of making information available to everybody, right? So that is what is the second paragraph about. The third paragraph says the critics say that this collaboration is an attempt by a large corporation to hide its real motives. Ethan says that he's not comfortable with this kind of an arrangement with SciArc, and he says that this project is a way of Google to promote itself, and they want to make the material accessible so the people find it wonderful. And at the core, it's all about advertisement and traffic. Also says that these images belong to the museum or the institution, where the objective is scholarly. The mission is very different. So this is a small paragraph. Let's directly write down what are we talking about. We are talking about critics here, right? Critics are against the Google SciArc thing. They feel that it's all basically a promotion gig, and there is a mission conflict. Matlab, these the use of these things should be done for educational and museum purposes, where the objectives are different. So there's a mission conflict, right? Okay. Last paragraph. There's another issue which archaeologists and historians believe. So again, there is further criticism going on, right? We are continuing with the criticism. So what archaeologists and historians believe that SciArc owns the copyright, the companies don't, which means SciArc's permissions is required to use these for commercial purposes, even for the company that owns those sites. So this is a kind of Western nation again trying to dominate the foreign culture. This is a kind of an old battle which is continuing. SciArc says that it copyrights the scan so that no one can use it in an inappropriate way, and it helps, it works with the local authorities and people, right? But the critics are not persuaded. They feel that the scans, so there is an argument about the copyright basically. The critics feel that the copyright should be belonging to the local, not to SciArc. That is a kind of criticism that is being brought up in the last paragraph. So this is what the passage is all about. The central idea exercise is done. Let me just go through these again. The first one is that there is a kind of destruction on archaeological sites, different kind of destructions, and Google does 3D preservation, but then Google's motivation and copyrights are being questioned here. Then we move to that these digital renditions by Google, they provide virtual lookups, and it's a non-profit tie-up that Google provides. But then comes the criticism that first that the Google SIARC non-profit tie-up, critics feel that it's all about promotion and the footfalls on Google, and there's a mission conflict. It's not for education purposes that Google does it. And further, the critics also say that the local country is not having the right over the content, the copyright issues. That is something which the critics do not agree with. So that is what this paragraph is all about. This is a CAT 2019 article. I hope the go-through part is clear. Thank you.